Students, in today's class, we will discuss our English poem 2, which is written by Vikram Seth, and the name of the poem is Rakhi. So, from the word Rakhi, the very first thought comes into our mind is a festival, Raksha Bandhan. Raksha Bandhan is a popular traditional Hindu annual rite or ceremony, which is celebrated in India, Nepal, and other parts of Indian subcontinent and among people around the world influenced by Hindu culture. Raksha Bandhan is the day of love and protection. This day is mainly celebrated between siblings to bestow their love and affection for each other. Sister tie Rakhi to her brother and pray to God for his well-being, and the brother pledges to protect her from evil. Now, in the beginning, I'll give the basic introduction of the author, Vikram Seth. He is an Indian author and poet. He was born in Calcutta on June 20th, 1952. He is known for his novels, The Golden Gate, which was published in 1986, and A Suitable Boy in 1993. He is an Indian poet and novelist. He has written poems on a range of topics such as family, siblings, encounters with strangers, about animals, and even cautious tales. He is best known for his collections of poetries, Beastly Sails, From Here and There, and Mapping, and also his novel A Suitable Boy. Vikram Seth has received several honors in his writing career, including the prestigious Sahitya Akademi Award for his first novel, The Golden Gate, in 1988, and the Padma Shri in 2000. Well, we have got to know many more facts about the poet. Now let's move on to our poem. I'll begin with reading it line by line, and then later on we'll discuss it pairwise. So firstly, students, let me sum it up in few lines to know what the poem is about and what whom it is related and dedicated to. It's a poem in which the speaker, upon receiving a Rakhi from his sister Aradhana, thinks about how his relationship with her has changed over the years. Now let's start reading the poem. I had forgotten the time of year your Rakhi came, showing how things have changed and are the same. It was a contract of trust with more than you, I know. I left home too many years ago. I placed the golden thread across my wrist that didn't struggle with my left hand to tie it on. You should have done that. I too have lost half the right. I promise you your gift in 78. Those future numerals look curious, and your brother too will be strange when next we meet each other. How we must both have changed. Only the custom stays, educing from the past the undying days. Here we end up our poem. Now let's begin the explanation part of it. Now let's start it from the para 1. I had forgotten the time of year your Rakhi came, showing how things have changed and are the same. Through this para, the poem starts with the Vikram telling his sister that he has forgotten the time of year her Rakhi was delivered to him. However, he states that no matter what time of year he received the Rakhi, some things will never change, that stays the same forever. So children, when we read this para, we got to know that the author has not met his family since long ago. His family, his sister, he has not met them. So through these lines, he is saying, you're showing how things have changed. As the year passes on, the things changed a lot, but their emotion, their bond remained the same. The same way Aradhana sent the Rakhi, like she used to send it before also. And are the same. This line states that many things has changed, but there are something which has never changed. Alright, next. It was a contract of trust with more than you. I know, I left home too many years ago. So through this para, he is saying, after all, the Rakhi was a contract of trust between the sibling. Vikram tells Aradhana that he knows that it was a contract, that it is made with more parties than just the two of them. He placed the Rakhi across his right wrist and struggled to tie it on with his left hand. Here the poet is saying that many years have went, but their trust remains the same. Till now, Aradhana sent him the Rakhi on Raksha Bandhan. This shows their bond, their affection for each other, their responsibility for each other. So children, when we read this para, the place, when he placed that golden thread across his wrist, this para shows his struggle, the efforts he need to make to tie that Rakhi on his wrist. So he's saying it was the duty of Aradhana to come and tie it, but he is tying here, struggling to tie it with one hand. Alright, next. You should have done that. I too have lost half the right. I promise you your gift in 78. This shows that he laments that he has forgotten half the sacred rites, and that she should have been the one to do the honor instead of him. He is all alone there. He has not met his sister now. So he is saying, I am doing all these rites and half of them I have forgotten. Instead of me, you should have been here and you should have been tying this Rakhi on my wrist. Next. Those future numerals look curious, and your brother too will be strange when next we meet each other. How we must both have changed, only the custom stays, educing from the past the undying days. So from this, he promises her that he will give her gifts in 78. He says that the numeral representation of his future date of their meeting looks curious. He tells her not to be surprised if they meet as strangers when they next see each other. However, changed both of them are, he is thankful that the customs will stay the same. Bringing from the past the undying days of settled traditions they have come to depend upon. So children, from the last few lines, what the author is saying, how much the time passes, whatever the situation it is, but these customs will remain same, which means Aradhana will continue sending him Rakhi forever until they are alive, and their bond will continue forever and ever. So here we end up our poem. Now children, we'll start with difficult words, and we have to do book exercises also. First, we will be discussing the difficult words which are mentioned in the book also. I have written it here so that you can copy down from here also in this video. My dear children, I hope you all have enjoyed this beautiful poem named Rakhi, which is authorized by a famous writer, Vikram Seth. Now let's move on to the book exercises. But before that, let's discuss the difficult words mentioned in the book. So children, after doing these difficult words, we'll move on to the book exercise, First, which is right, true or false. And then second, answer the following question. And the last one is extract from the poem. Now children, let's begin doing the difficult words. So the first one is contract, which means an agreement between two people. So student, in this poem, contract means when a sister ties the rakhi around the wrist of her brother, and in return he pledged to protect her from any evil. Actually, contract means an agreement between the two people, but here we have a different meaning. Okay, next one, rite, a traditional ceremony. Tying rakhi is a traditional ceremony which has been followed since long back in our country. Okay, so rite, it is a traditional ceremony which is to be followed. Then the third one, educing. Here, reliving through memories. Educing here in this poem says that the poet tried to say that the time will pass on, but the memories will stay forever. So he is reliving through these memories when Aradhana used to tie the rakhi herself on his wrist. Alright, next one is undying, which means never ending. Undying means never ending. Those memories will never end when she used to tie the rakhi herself when they lived together. But now the time has changed and they are apart now. So children, here we end up our difficult words. Now let's move on further by doing book exercises. And the first book exercise is write the true or false. Let's start the book exercise first, which is write true or false. First one, the speaker knew that Raksha Bandhan was round the corner. This is false. Second, the speaker left his home 2 years ago. This one again is false, because we have read it in the poem also. The speaker has left his home long back. Many years has went when he has left his home. Third one, the speaker ties the rakhi himself. This one is true. Of course, because he is alone. In the absence of his sister Aradhana, he himself has to tie that rakhi around his wrist. And the struggle he has mentioned in the poem also, as we have discussed this before. Fourth, the speaker promises to give his sister a gift in the future. This one again is true. He promises her that he will gift her for this Raksha Bandhan. As on the eve of Raksha Bandhan, she has sent the rakhi. So now it's his duty, as being a brother, he has to gift her something. Alright. Now let's proceed further by doing answer the following questions. I'll read the question answers and then we'll discuss it. Question number 1. Why does the speaker say that things have changed between him and his sister and are yet the same? Now let's read the answer. Things have changed between the speaker and his sister in the sense that earlier the speaker's sister could tie the rakhi around his wrist as they stayed together. They could enjoy each other's company. They cannot do it now, for they live apart. What has remained the same, however, is that she never forgets to send the rakhi to him. Their bond is still strong. So children, when we read this answer, this shows that their bond is very strong, still very strong. After living so far from each other, living apart from each other since long time, many things have changed. They are staying, before they used to stay together, but now they are staying apart, far from each other. But that one thing has remained the same is that she never forgets to send a Rakhi to him. She never forgets to send the Rakhi to her brother. And this shows that their bond is still very strong. Their bond, which include the care and affection for a sister, the protection which is sent by a brother for his sister, and a love sent by a sister for her brother. So these are some things which are yet the same. Okay, let's proceed further. Question number 2. What contract of trust does the speaker refers to? The contract of trust was the promise between the speaker and his sister that they would never forget each other, no matter what the situation is, how far apart they were. His sister sent him a Rakhi around the date of the festival of Raksha Bandhan, showing the contract of trust. This answer states that after living apart from each other, staying so far from each other, and since many years they are living apart, but till now, till the date, his sister sends the Rakhi on the eve of Raksha Bandhan to him. This shows the contract of trust. So this contract of trust was the promise between the brother and a sister that they would never forget each other, how far apart they were, and whatever the situation it is, they would never forget each other, and their bond will remain same forever. Next question, question 3. What future numerals does the speaker talk about? Why do these numerals look curious to him? Answer: the future numerals refers to the numerals 7 and 8 of the year 78 or 1978. The speaker plans to be at home for Rakhi in 1978. When the speaker stayed together with his family long ago, he could hand her the Rakhi gift as soon as she tied the Rakhi. Now, he must wait for a long time till he gets to do that. Hence, the number of years 78 appears curious or strange to him that he gets to see his sister so rarely now. So in this answer, 78 are some future numerals, some dates which the author has planned in future when he'll be going to his home back on the eve of Rakhi, the Raksha Bandhan, and when his sister tied the Rakhi around his wrist, he would offer her with the Rakhi gifts. So it also appear curious or strange to him because it's very strange for him to see his sister so rarely now. Alright. Next, question number 4. What does the custom of tying a Rakhi remind the speaker of? Answer: the custom of tying a Rakhi reminds the speaker that both he and his sister must have changed a lot. They can never return to the past. Only the customs of celebrating Raksha Bandhan has remained unchanged. They can only relive those happy days over and over again through their shared memories. So children, when we read this answer, we got to know that time never comes back once it is past. So the custom of tying a Rakhi reminds the speaker that both he and his sister must have changed a lot. When in future, the date which he has planned for going his home back on the eve of Raksha Bandhan. So when they will meet each other after this much long time, it would be a very big change for both of them. It would be very big change, right? They can never return to the past. They can only remember those memories when his sister Aradhana herself used to tie the rakhi around the wrist of his brother, of her brother, sorry. So they could only remember those memories which they have gone through. But one thing that will never change, that will remain same forever, is that they will share that bond forever. The customs of Raksha Bandhan will never change. The rituals and rites will never change. Many things have changed. After a long time, when we meet someone, it is a big change for us to meet them, to know something new about them. But there are some rituals, there are some customs which will remain same forever. And one of them is that she will continue sending the rakhis on Raksha Bandhan to her brother. So children, here we end up our answer the following question, the second exercise of a poem. Now let's move on further to the next exercise, that is extract. Now children, this is our third exercise from the poem, which is extract. First I will read the extract and then we will discuss question answers from it. Read the lines from the poem and answer the following question. You should have done that. I too have lost half the right. Question 1. What right does the poet refers to? Here, the poet refers to the right of sister tying rakhi around the wrist of her brother. So, these are some rites and rituals which are followed, and tying rakhi is part of these rites. Alright, next question. Why does the speaker have to perform the rite himself? Answer. The speaker has to perform the rite himself because his sister is not there with him. She is at home far away. So, from this answer, what we could understand is the author himself has to perform the rites as they live apart. So, she could not be present at that moment when the rakhi is to be tied. And so, her brother is performing the rite of tying that rakhi himself. He is suffering all alone. Now, question number 3. Why does the speaker say that he has lost half the right? The other half of the right is the brother handing his sister her rakhi gift with his own hands, as he stay far away from home and his sister, he cannot have his sister tie the rakhi in person. So he says that he has lost half the right. So children, in this answer the speaker says so because in this case he stay far away from home and his sister, so he cannot have his sister tie the rakhi in person. So he say that he has lost half the right, and other half of the right is the brother handing his sister her rakhi gift with his own hands. Alright, now let's move further to the question number 4. What do you think the speaker's feeling are in this point? Answer. The speaker is sad at this point. He cannot have his sister tie the rakhi around his wrist, nor can he give her a rakhi gift. He misses his sister a lot, and the wonderful time they spent together when they were children. So children, as we have read it in the poem also, he cannot have his sister tie Rakhi around his wrist. And as they live apart, he cannot even give her the Rakhi gift. So at this moment, the author is feeling sad and misses his sister a lot. And also he misses the wonderful time they had during their childhood. And this we could understand from the answer where he has written, he misses his sister a lot and the wonderful time they spent together when they were children. So students, here we end up our poem. It was a very short, a very beautiful and a sweet poem which showed a very sweet bond of a brother and sister. It's a poem in which the speaker, upon receiving a Rakhi from his sister, thinks about how his relationship with her has changed over the years. The poet has described it very beautifully, sharing his experience of Raksha Bandhan, festival of love and affection for the siblings. Now students, as you all could see, I have written the book exercises also, which were mentioned in the book. I know you all might not be having your books, so these exercises you can just copy from this video and copy down the poem also, so that you can read it at your home. One more important thing, I will be sending the exercises including question answer extracts etc. in your class group on WhatsApp. Till then, bye bye and take care. And do not forget to stay home and stay healthy. Thank you.